When you say that to you it looks as though they're two-thirds on the way toward the bottom now, does that mean, is it as simple as saying that there's still a one-third depreciation left in their currencies before they're able to reach that point where they can, where the currencies are cheap enough to attract new capital and restore the balance of payments?
Yeah. Speaking as a generalization, I'm saying that they are, that if those place out classically, what they'll have is large fiscal deficits. And how they choose to monetize those fiscal deficits or how they choose to restructure their balance sheets through IMF loans or through the tightening of monetary policy will be the determinant of the exact bottoms in those currencies, right? And so, but just generally speaking, the greater of the moves is behind us, the greater of the concern. We will have a lot of panic, more panic. And you'll have that. And as the saying goes, the time to buy is when there's blood in the streets, right? And to know when there's value, and those are the calculations one has to do.
Is there enough blood in the streets yet to see value?
I think we're getting there, generally speaking. And I think it's important also, that's that case of inflationary depressions. I think we should also think of the types of depressions that we go through, because I think that's also interesting.